This video app review is brought to you by the iPhoneAppReview.com.
What's up, guys? This is Luke Patrick with the iPhoneAppReview.com. Today we're slinging out yet another video review, this time taking a look at a very fun application called QuizPix that's right here. And this actually is my first review anyway on the new iOS 7 on my iPhone 5, so let's do the nice parallax effect that happens there. Alright, enough of that. Let's go ahead and jump into it. I'm going to turn off the ringer just so that you can hear me a little bit better. The music is fine, but we're kind of narcissistic like that. It just makes things simpler if we can do this. Alright, so let's go ahead and play this. Basically, the game is best described as sort of Pictionary on your phone. Ask me later. I'm reading it currently via video review. But this is the basic concept that you will be dealing with. So, for instance, I have... that will get rid of your letters. Let me explain this better. Basically, Pictionary for your phone is the best way that I know to describe it, in that you get a visual cue, and then it pertains to the category that you happen to be playing. So, for instance, that's brands. There's also phrases, bands, and that's pretty much it at this point, though these will take you quite a while to work through. You simply begin with brands, and then you can work to the other ones by unlocking them, which you do have to play the game to do. There is no charge associated with this game, though you can purchase coins if you would like. You simply tap the button up here, and then you can buy coins for X amount of money. We're not going to do that, but why would you want that? Well, for instance, we have right here a cue, which I'm still puzzling over. I have yet to figure this one out, and of course someone's going to view this and be like, well, duh, it's this. Anyway, we'll get there in a second. But let's say I'm stuck. I can simply tap the hints button and then spend money to actually get a hint or reveal a letter or whatever, which I may have to do here in a second, but I'm going to just sort of go ahead and guess. Obviously, I've messed up because the timer is red. This will begin and then tick over until it is red. If you happen to solve it before the timer is up, then you'll get 15 coins. If you don't and you just solve it after, then you'll get 3. So, let us just try something here. It's a sleeping star, so star... Honestly, I don't know, so let's go ahead and let's retrieve all of my letters. Then hint, hint. No, I don't want to spin, sorry. Reveal a letter is what I'm after. Yes, alright, there we go. And beyond this, I don't know, honestly. Well, I'm going to take a second to go puzzle this out, but I will be right back in just a second, so I don't waste any more of your time. See you in a second. Alright guys, I'm back, and many apologies. I forgot that if you type it in, it automatically says if you've done it correctly. But I did guess it, so if you were paying attention to the few seconds before this, it was Napster. Which does indicate one aspect of the application, in that sometimes the clues and the hints or the visuals and the actual solutions don't quite line up exactly as we might like. For instance, Napster isn't really spelled star, it's spelled S-T-E-R. Then again, this is an international game, so small nuances like that may go quite unnoticed at some point. But anyway, that's the basic concept. So of course we get 3 coins for it. And then it's on to the next clue, and of course you have the same interface, the same fairly well-designed interface. It's not the most fabulous one we've ever seen, and the same visual cues as well. I believe this one is the infamous Dr. Pepper, so I'm going to type that in, and then you can see what it's like to solve a puzzle. Of course, you get 15 coins for it. The next button, so again, cleverly designed, very well designed. It's a very rugged and very solid application. We have no fear that it will fail on you. Furthermore, you do get a ton of content for the money, which is, of course, nothing. This is a free application, so it costs nothing to play all the way through each of these 3 levels. Though, of course, you can pick coins if you want, or purchase coins if you would like. We like the visuals, the drawn visuals. You know, all in all, it's a very, very fun game, and it is also very challenging at times. Obviously, I'm having some trouble with some of these clues. It didn't start out this way. It does ease you in pretty well, and then beyond that, it can get quite difficult, which is good for any puzzle game. All in all, basically, we're trying to say it's a very solid game, and it's one that's a lot of fun. The price tag also makes it way worth your time if you're a puzzling fanatic on the iPhone. So basically, we're going to sum all of this up by saying it's a 4.5 out of 5-star rating from us, as well as a heavy recommendation if you're looking for a new puzzle game with a word focus to plug around with. So that, I believe I know what this one is, so let's go ahead and solve it. Greenpeace. There we go. That's all we have to say about it, so I'm going to go ahead and sign out, but we will see you guys later. Bye.